Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Protech. Rising OS is known for its amazing customizations, features and its beautiful look. In our last uploaded video of Rising OS 8.0 Zorya version, we did in-depth review of Android 16 version of Rising OS. We'll find that video link in iCard and in description. Finally, team has started to roll out their another update version, Rising OS 8.8.1 Arte, for all official devices via custom ROM and via GSI version, which can be bootable on any device. In this video, we are going to review this amazing ROM, its new changes and features, and at the end of this video, we've shown which previous bugs are now resolved in the GSI build and which bugs still persist in this version, with my final verdict. So both custom ROM and GSI users of this ROM will get clear idea do they need to update or not to this version. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I booted the GSI version of this ROM via disk loader on my OnePlus 9RT. If you are already using the GSI as a primary ROM, you will get the OTA of this version. Just download and flash it. For both DSU and fastboot installation process, please follow our video links given in the description. If we check the about device details of this version, here on the front page it mentioned that this is the new Rising OS official GSI build, version 8.1.1 RD. Android version is same, it's Android 16, but this build is now based on the QPR0 source code. Rising OS team introduced this new Rising OS Easter egg from the last Zorya version. Security patches of this build is of latest September 2025. Build date of ROM is of 13 September 2025. With this new update, you will get latest base of Android 16. Now we'll check out all the new changes and the features of this update. In the personalization setting and under the themes tab, team added new lock and unlock sound. Bunch of different sounds are available here, but my favorite one is Minecraft door unlock and lock sound. Next, in the previous versions of this ROM, always on display image feature was not working, but now in this build it's working great. We also got this new screen of AOD, so this AOD image will also be visible on the always on display, which gives the amazing look to your device when your device screen is off. In lock screen and widgets, for device info widget, we got the new battery temperature and level information. As you already know that the device info widgets are not interactive widgets and also visible on the AOD even if the screen is off. These AOD images, widgets and oneui now bar gives similar look of nothing goes always on widgets on your lock screen. In the previous versions of Rising OS, if we enable all mini, big and device info widgets along with navbar, it causes some misalignments of widgets on the lock screen. But now, the device info and other big and mini widgets are properly aligned and looking great on the lock screen. Peak display is a great feature which is inspired from Motorola's bubble notification, which is now well aligned in this build and working smoothly as compared to the previous version. Peak display notifications are now also visible on the always on display. If you set the navbar and the peak display with proper settings of all widgets, navbar and the peak display notification will give us one stop solution to keep watch on your device without unlocking your phone. Next, under the themes, we get the new scale and slide animations for overall Windows system animations. These both animation effects gives another level of user interface experience for your device. But my favorite one is a scale one, which have somewhat bouncy animation to overall Windows animation. These are the main visible changes of this update. We'll edit it. Other features review of this ROM, you can check that video through link given in the iCard. Next are some fixes of new Rising OS. The first one is the punch hole camera cutout issue is now completely fixed for all left side punch hole camera devices. All basic functions are working, including Bluetooth, which was buggy in the old version. Even the VoLT calls and the networks are working now. For calling feature, please check the treble setting solution given in the description. Google Circle to search is also working good, but you have to download the Google application once you install the ROM. Similarly, install the Google Assistant application from the Play Store and set its trigger while long press power button setting. It's also working great without any issue. Next, for miscellaneous setting of the travel application, we got the new two toggles. One is LMK tweaks and another one is disable expense or rendering power mode. Both of these settings are useful for low-end devices. You can enable it if you are facing any kind of lags. Both of these settings along with 120Hz screen refresh rate gives the new level of fluidity while using new Rising OS Arte. It's flying like never before, everything is buttery smooth now. Let's check out the bugs of this ROM. Similar like old version, this ROM have fingerprint sensor issue. It's not working for under display fingerprint devices, but it's working for devices having a physical fingerprint button. We can also use face unlock. It's working good and it gives the blazing fast unlocking experience for your device. Next is a major issue of the GSI ROM. ROM have quick switch setting to switch between different launchers like Arte, Launcher and Pixel. But only Pixel launcher is working, other two may give you different types of issues. So as per my recommendation, don't use other launchers. But even if you use the Pixel launcher, we get one bug. We can't able to access long press menu on the home screen. So we can't able to add widgets on the home screen. Even we can't able to access wallpaper and style setting. To change the wallpaper or icon and its themes, we can access the wallpaper and style setting through main settings application. For OnePlus devices, alert slider is not working. ROM didn't pass any kind of play integrity checks, but if your device is not rooted, you can able to use all major banking and payment applications like SBI, HDFC, PhonePe, Google Pay, WhatsApp, Axis Bank, and even if you can use RailOne, which is working in this ROM. Except the bug of fingerprint and the launcher issue, everything is working now. So I think this version of Rising OS is the most stable version 8 with lots of amazing user interface tweaks and new features which will transform your Android 16 into the new version that you can't find in any of stock or custom ROM. So in my opinion, this is the number one ROM which is better than any ROM out in the market. This is all about for today guys, hope you like our work, then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to custom ROMs, GSI and Android mods. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.